Good morning, students. Welcome back to biology classroom once again. I hope all of you have watched the last video. In the last video, I have discussed the epithelium complex tissue. So today I am going to teach you the muscular tissue. So look at the book. The muscle tissues or muscles of the body form the contractile tissue, are made of muscle cells. Contractile tissue means they can expand easily. I mean, we contract them easily. That's why these muscles are also known as contractile tissue. Muscle cells are elongated and large size, so they are called muscle fiber. So cells are basically cylindrical and large size. They are also known as muscles fiber. On the basis of their location, structure and functions, there are following three types of muscle fiber. Straight muscles, unstraight or smooth muscles, and last one is cardiac muscles. Next, straight muscles. Straight muscles are also known as striped skeletal or voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles means those muscles are basically accordingly are under control. I mean, those muscles basically when work, we can control the muscles. These muscles are also known as voluntary muscles. So same way, straight muscles are voluntary muscles. Since the entire muscle fiber shows alternate dark and light stripes, basically they are in a elongated strips and fiber-like structure. So each stripe shows different color. Either one fiber shows light color, so another stripe shows dark color. They are called stripped muscles. Since they are attached to the bones and are responsible for the body movement. So what are they? Basically, skeletal, I mean striped voluntary muscles attached to the bones and specially responsible for our body movements. For body movements, the skeletal or voluntary muscles, striped voluntary muscles help us. They are called skeletal muscles. And lastly, since these muscles work according to our will, they are also known as voluntary muscles. The straight muscles fiber are long or elongated, non-tapering. Non-tapering means they have no pit-like structure at the end point of each cell. They are cylindrical and unbranched. I mean, each cell is not dividing any another branch. They are unbranched. Straight muscles occur in the muscles of limbs. Limbs means biceps and triceps of arms, body wall of face, neck, etc. Straight muscles present in the tongue, pharynx, diaphragm and upper part of esophagus called visceral straight muscles. Underline this word. What is visceral straight muscle? So which kind of straight muscles are found in the upper part of esophagus? They are known as visceral straight muscles. Next, straight muscles are powerful because they help to our body movements and undergo rapid contraction. They contract easily. So these muscles can get tired and may need rest. They provide the force for locomotion. Basically, they help to locomote our body from one place to another and all other voluntary movements of the body, and they control the another voluntary movements of our body. Next, unstraight muscles or smooth muscles. Unstraight muscles occur as bundles or sheets of elongated fusiform or spindle-shaped cell or fiber. So the unstraight muscles basically not elongated, they are fused with each other. They have no proper ends like spindle shaped. These are held together by loose connective tissue. I mean, each muscles can combine together with loose connective tissue. Basically, connective tissue help to fuse them and make them spindle shaped. These muscles are found in the wall of hollow visceral organ except that of the heart. These muscles are found in the wall of hollow visceral organ. So they are called visceral muscles. Thus, they occur in the wall of alimentary canal and internal organ, duct of glands, urogenital ducts and blood vessels. These muscles are found in this type of places. Smooth muscles are found in stomach, intestine, ureter, bronchi, iris of eye, etc. Smooth muscles do not work according to our will. So, they are also called involuntary muscles. So, those kind of muscles are not under control. They are involuntary muscles. Same way, unstrained muscles are not under control. Movement of food in the alimentary canal, opening and closing tubes are involuntary movements. Learn the points. The strongest muscle in our body is the muscles of jaw. So, which is the strongest muscles in our body? That is the muscles of jaw. The heart muscle is the hardest working muscle. Cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle show characteristic of both smooth and straight muscles. So, it show the both character, smooth muscles as well as straight muscles. Cardiac muscles are composed of branched fiber. Basically, which kind of muscles are composed in cardiac muscles? The muscles are branched-like. They divide into thin branches. And branches join to form a network. The branch joined and form a network. They have stripes of light and dark bands. Because it shows the character of stripe muscle. That's why it shows the different bands like light and dark bands. Cardiac muscles are present in the wall of heart only. Underline this word. Cardiac muscle is only found in the wall of heart. Cardiac muscles contract and relax rapidly, rhythmically and tirelessly throughout a lifetime. They contract endlessly from early embryonic stage until death. So, what is the main function of cardiac muscle? Cardiac muscle contract and relax rapidly, rhythmically and tirelessly throughout a lifetime. They contract endless from the embryonic stage from the birth date to till death day. So for today, up to this